everybody, and welcome to the MTV studios. Now, today is a very special day. We have with us a hand-picked, specially selected studio audience from all over Europe, and we're all here to meet a lady who is one of the massive success stories over the past year. Her debut single, Torn, stormed the charts. Her album, Left of the Middle, was a huge success with critics and with fans. It went double platinum, and it also entered into the top 10 album chart in America. She's with us for the next hour, everybody. Welcome, Natalie Imbruglia!
Thank you. That was lovely. I think that's the best intro I've ever heard. Thank you.
She's flattering me now. Now, Natalie, before I let these guys let rip with their questions, mm-hmm. I want to ask you a couple myself.
Okay.
Right, firstly, because I know, you know, you have to do so many promotions and interviews and TV things with all these kind of singles that come out. What is the most annoying thing that people ask you?
Probably, you know, those lots of ten questions where they say, if you were a colour, what colour would you be? And they go down this whole list of... And it usually comes in lots of ten.
Is that really annoying because you have to sit there for hours?
Exactly. And they start on the first one and, you know, for the next 10 questions, it's going to be downhill. So that's probably my worst.
And people really read things into them, don't they?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
She likes that.
And if you're not really quick off the mark and funny, because I'm not very funny, so I don't have, like, a bunch of answers up my sleeve. So I sit there and go, oh, God, what colour would I be if I was a colour?
Nobody's got what animal would you be if you were an animal, have they here? No.
They're probably the most annoying questions.
If you have, don't ask it. Okay, just leave that one. What's the nicest kind of questions that you like?
The best questions are probably when...
Ones you haven't been asked before.
Yes, and also when they don't call you like a big pop star, when they say, you know, talk to you as a person. Right. That's probably my favourite kind of question.
Right. Now, the thing that really annoys me, I have to say, is when people pretend that they can't pronounce your name.
Oh, yeah, because everybody...
I'm like, get over it. She's been around for years. It's Imbruglia.
Exactly.
Big Italian.
Exactly.
Big Italian. Exactly. Okay. Now, Natalie, I'm going to let the guys ask you some questions now. So first of all, we've got Ariana from Monaco.
Ooh. Wow.
There was a 3-year gap in between quitting Neighbours and relaunching as a singer. Was there a reason for this?
Initially, I was hoping to not have any gaps. I wanted it to kind of go on to the next stage. But I was actually hoping to come to London and work on stage and do plays. But I had problems with visas and work permits, so I actually was in a bit of a pickle career-wise. So it wasn't intentional at the beginning, but in hindsight, it was probably the best thing because I had time to think about what I really wanted to do and started songwriting and, you know, committed to making a record, so...
Completely changed direction.
Yeah.
Did you ever get approached to be a singer, or was it
when I was 14?
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah, actually, before I was on Neighbours, there was I auditioned for a girly band.
Sweet.
Yeah, so I did the dancing audition, and then he had to come in and sing, and I passed that. And they actually said that I was too individual to be part of a group because, you know, I can't really conform to So then they wanted to sign me as a solo artist, and I said no. And that was when I was 14.
It's good that you waited, though.
Yeah, it was. Gut instinct, it wasn't going to be right, so.
Now, you've heard it so many times. I mean, on the radio, it's been on the television, it's been absolutely everywhere. Torn.
Yep.
Has it changed for you now, the meaning of it, or the sound of it, or has it developed in any way?
A little bit. I think it's weird because it's a really sad song, and when I first did it, I was in this really depressed space. And now, it's done so much for me that I guess it's kind of more of a positive thing when I sing it, which is kind of weird because it's a sad song, but I guess it's good, it's uplifting because I've had a brilliant year because of that song. So.
Okay, well, let's take a quick break now from the questions and see you performing Torn.
Couldn't be that man I adore. to care what your heart is for. Well, I don't know him anymore. He's not fitting where he used to lie. The conversation has run dry. That's what's going on. Nothing's fine at all. I'm all out of fear. This is how. Changed into something real. Wide awake and I can see the perfect sky is torn. You're a little man, I'm already torn. So I guess the fortune teller's right. I should have seen just what was there and not some holy light. Beneath my veins now. I don't care, I have no luck. I don't miss it all that much. There's just so many things that I can't touch or touch. I'm all out of fear. This is how I feel. I'm cold and I am shamed. Lying naked on the floor. Illusion never changed into something real. See the perfect sky is torn. You're a little late. I'm already torn. Torn. There's nothing where I used to lie. Inspiration has run dry. Well, that's what's going on. Nothing's right at all. I'm all out of bed. This is how I feel. Cold and I am shamed. Lying naked on the floor. Illusion never changed into something real. Wide awake and I can see the perfect sky is torn.
Natalie performing Torn at the MTV studios. I've got another question for you now.
Okay.
Now, you've had a lot of fame and a lot of success since you were really young, but tons in the last sort of year and a half.
Yes.
Does it bring you happiness or has it brought you problems?
It brings mostly happiness, yeah. I mean, I think, excuse me, the only stressful part is you're very busy. So, you know, that's the only problem, though. I mean, you get to travel. And it's all good.
Now, has anybody got a question for Natalie? Who have I got down here? Simon from Surrey?
Yeah.
Simon, hello.
Hi, Simon.
Hi, Natalie. What's the best thing about fame and what's the worst?
I think the best thing is, well, I love singing. I love music. So to be able to do that and earn a living out of it is amazing. The worst thing is probably not having enough free time and just having sometimes your personal life splurted all over the papers. That's probably the worst part of it.
Next one is from Barbara from Canada.
Hi, Barbara.
Hi. What do people get wrong about you?
What do people get wrong about me?
That's a good question.
Yeah, it is a good question. I think a lot of people expect that when they're going to meet me that I'm going to be this really miserable sod. And because my songs are quite sad, and you know, people are like, gosh, you're quite chirpy considering. So that's, yeah, I think people expect that if you can access that and write songs like that, that you get around morbidly or you've had some tortured past, and I haven't really. David from Surrey. David.
Hi.
Do you get nervous performing in front of a large crowd?
Yes, I do. I get really moody. I get quite, like, if anybody does anything out of place, I'm like, rah, rah, rah. I get really stressed out. And when it's like a festival or there's like a massive audience, I get this, especially like when I did Party in the Park as well, because it was like London and I hadn't really done any gigs here. I was just sick to the stomach. And then I go on stage and it's just the, yeah, you just let it all out. I think it's the anticipation, because they'll be like, oh, it's delayed for 20 minutes and you're like pacing. And then you just kind of want to get all this energy out. And then when you finally go out there, it's just the best feeling, and then everyone's smiling and singing along, and it's great.
Do you ever forget your lyrics? Watch the audience, I'll be able to tell you.
That's happened to me before.
Has it really?
It happened in Belgium. I was singing along, and I think it was City, and completely forgot the words. But for some reason, instead of like getting nervous and crying, I was actually found it quite funny, and I was going, and so I was thinking to myself, this is going on for a really long time, when am I going to remember? And then kicked in the chorus, but...
Oh.
They kept smiling, and I don't think anyone really noticed, actually.
Just hum along. Hum along to yourself. Mm. So another one from Grania.
Is it fun making videos, and what's your favourite video that you've done, and why?
Video making is really fun, especially because probably I started in acting, so it's my chance to do a little bit of acting. My favourite video is the Torn video, by far, because it was the most fun to make.
It's a great video.
Simple.
That's my favourite. Time for another one of your tracks.
Okay.
Now, this one's Frightened Child.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that was a B-side, wasn't
yes.
it? And I know you particularly like this track, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
And now, do you feel when you put something on a B-side that you're kind of maybe throwing it away a little bit because it's not going to be a single?
No. I think B-sides are really, really important. Just as important as any track on the album. And any artist that I've been really into. I'm just as keen to hear the B-sides, probably more so to hear the B-sides.
Mm.
So I think it's not like a throwaway track, you know. And this is cute because it's like, it's not a normal structure, and it's quite a short song, and it's just, it's really sweet.
Okay, well, here it is, Frightened Child.
Deep in your private dream, 2 ways to go from here, 1 way will bring you near. Fried child wish, full moon, no rain, no shame. Well, that distance still remains. More shades of gray to come. We've been through more than one. Close your eyes. Like a frightened child, fragile in the spirit, like a wind blowing wild, no name you can give it, like an infidel seeing the light for the very first time. No tricks, no sleight of hand, find somewhere safe to land. Before your walls were shaking, but now the whole thing's breaking. And it makes me feel like a frightened child, fragile in the spirit, like a wind blowing wild. No name you can give it, like an infidel seeing the light for the very first time. Yes, you're right. Shows, yes, I know you're a beautiful stranger to yourself.
So that was Natalie with the Frightened Child. Thank you very much for that.
It's all right.
Recorded here at our specially designed studio. All this is specially for you, Natalie.
All for me. It is lovely.
Yes. Now we're heading to a short break, but don't worry, because we'll have more questions, more Natalie, and a lot more music. So we'll see you then. Welcome back. Natalie, you seem quite well settled in London.
Mm.
Do you like it as a place?
I love it.
You do?
Yeah.
So, City, tell me about that song, because it's really quite a heavy song. Was it about London?
Yes. Yeah. Basically, it was one of the first songs I wrote, and it's the most autobiographical song. So it is about me being a little bit bitter and twisted and jaded and, you know, I guess, yeah, it's all about what I went through and, you know, people that I got rid of out of my life and that kind of thing. So I was over London, and I think that's why I love London so much, because I went through such a hard time and went through a period where I hated it and I actually couldn't leave. I was like skint and I was in this situation, and now I wouldn't leave, so.
And we love having you, Natalie. I just want to let you know that. Here she is performing City, Natalie Imbruglia. Yeah!
Yeah.
Natalie Imbruglia performing City, which was from her album Left of the Middle. And now I think it's time for some more questions from our studio audience. So first of all, let's kick off with one from Dave from Birmingham.
Okay. You've spent the last year touring. What's it like and how did you cope with the stress, both mentally and physically?
Whew. Well, it can be quite difficult. I haven't been on the road as such too much. I had a couple of weeks in Europe and I've got a tour coming up. But promoting is really, really tough. Yeah. It's not very rock and roll because you really have to be quite disciplined because you're working long hours. So you do have to get to bed by a certain hour. And when you're singing, you can't really drink and smoke and do all those things. So it's actually quite hardcore, but I quite like a bit of discipline. I think it's good.
Boys, did you hear that? Natalie quite likes a bit of discipline. Okay. Alexandra from Sweden.
Hello.
How did you feel when your album had entered the charts in the top 10 in the US?
Amazing. I actually couldn't believe it. Imagine being told that.
Straight in at number 10.
I was like, I couldn't believe it. Really couldn't believe
it. Were your record company just going mad?
Yeah, everybody was going mad.
Were you getting hampers full of champagne and truffles?
It's funny because we were supposed to be... It's really weird when a song breaks everywhere at the one time because every country's like, you have to come here now!
We need you!
Yeah.
So what did you do?
I went to America, didn't I?
And you went everywhere. You were in America.
Yeah, I did. I started in the States. I was all everywhere over Europe. Went to Australia and that was fun. That was great, yeah.
Can I just ask you, Natalie's got a piercing
in a very weird spot.
In the inner sanctuary of her ear. Did that hurt?
In there.
You see in there? Did that hurt, like...
It hurt for 2 seconds while they were doing it, yes. But excruciating pain while they were doing it. Actually felt more like pressure.
What about sleeping on it?
It's fine, because if you get a piercing here, then when you go to sleep, it hurts. Because it's inside your ear, you can just... No, it's actually, after the piercing was done, yeah. It was fine. And when they
it's
put the
really
jewellery through.
Though.
It's good, isn't it?
It's very,
thank
very
you.
Pretty. People. Right, next one. Paul from Birmingham.
Hi, Natalie.
Hi, how you doing?
Which other artists have influenced you?
I think inspiration's a better word, because I think I'm still in the learning stages. So I don't really feel like I take influences from anybody except the people who I co-write with. It's more inspiration, and I get that from Stevie Wonder, I get that from Sean Colvin, who's one of my favourite, Joni Mitchell.
I've only just found her.
Really?
I've only just discovered her.
Isn't she amazing?
She's amazing. Have any of you guys heard of Sean Colvin?
Yeah, she's
I'm
brilliant.
Obviously the last person in the world.
Well, I actually was into... Basically, Sean Colvin broke in the States on her third album. A song called Sunny Came Home, but I liked her first two albums before anybody knew who she was.
Oh, well, I better go.
Yeah, you should. Yeah, she's brilliant.
She's fantastic.
So people like that, I guess.
Dave from Birmingham.
Hi.
Hi. Which bands do you like at the moment?
I really like Gomez, actually.
Yeah.
I think they're brilliant, as far as contemporary stuff goes. And there's an Australian band that... I heard recently called Regurgitator that's really quite good. They're really brilliant musicians, but they've got this futuristic sound and all these funny sounds that they put to the music, but the music's really good and the lyrics are really, really funny. So they're two new...
Regurgitation.
Regurgitator.
Regurgitator. Anthony from Newcastle.
Okay. 10 out of the 12 tracks on your album were co-written by you. How important is it that you get recognition for this?
I think it's more important that I have input than it is to get recognition, because I think you could beat yourself up, you know, till you're blue in the face not getting recognition. I think what's more important is, you know, knowing yourself how much you put into it and whether you can justify to yourself, you know, a lot of this album is me, and I can say that a lot of this album is. So I think that was more important to me than what anyone else was going to say or think about it.
Next one is Bianca from France.
I heard that you have been working with Dave Stewart. How did that come about?
Dave's great. I met Dave in a restaurant in Covent Garden.
Did you?
Yeah, Belgo's.
How funny.
Yeah, and he came up to me and he was like, oh, I really like your album. And I was like, you're amazing. And yeah, I was actually quite drunk that night. And he invited myself and my friends back to his place to play some music and everything. And
oh, yeah.
I was like...
We've heard that before.
No!
Come out and listen to my music.
No.
I'm joking.
please. So we went back there and I was being all confident and, you know, Dutch courage. And dancing around and singing. And I woke up in the morning and I remembered that I'd arranged to work with him on the Friday. And I was like, oh, my God. I was really embarrassed. And I had to kind of humbly knock on the door and, you know, hi. And I was really shy and really, really nervous.
But
he's absolutely amazing. He's a brilliant, brilliant, genius person to work with. So I'm looking forward to having the time in January to just, you know, complete some things with him, because we have written some songs, but we haven't had the time to really.
Next question is from Gemma from London.
Hi, Natalie.
Hello.
Someone's commented that your album sounds more like a third album than a first album. Did you have a really clear idea of how you wanted it to sound?
I didn't. I actually didn't have a plan or think, okay, I want to make an album that sounds like that. What was most important, I remember just thinking, I just really want it to be me, I want it to be honest, and I didn't give myself any guidelines except that.
Next question is from Alexandra from Sweden.
The album is called Left of the Middle. Does this describe the style or attitude of your music?
That's a good question. No, because a lot of people think I called it Left of the Middle because the music's left of center, but it's actually not. It's more about how I feel sometimes. It's more of a personal thing, feeling off balance or feeling out of center, and that was my way of saying it, being left of the middle. So it's more of a personal thing than about the music.
Great. Okay, now the next song you've chosen to perform for us is Something Better.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's listen to it. Here she is singing Something Better, Natalie Imbruglia. Yeah.
Something better comes along.
hopefully with something better. We're heading for a short break, but do come back to join us for more chat and more music. Welcome back, and here we are interviewing Natalie Imbruglia. Now, we're very lucky because we can ask Natalie whatever we want, except if you were a colour, what colour would you be?
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. So, who's dying to ask Natalie a question? Who have I got down here? Alexandra from Sweden. Hello.
Hello.
Who or what is your greatest inspiration in your life?
Oh, whoa, heavy question. I don't think it's any person in particular. I think people are my inspiration and probably the underdog, you know? I like seeing people kind of struggle and come through difficulties, and that kind of thing really inspires me. So probably the underdog.
Dave from Birmingham.
Hi again.
Hello.
If you hadn't been so successful first with acting and now music, did you have an alternative career you could fall back onto?
Well, that's a good question.
Yeah, it is a good question. And the answer is probably not. That's probably why I'm so driven, I think, because there's not really...
You can't fail.
Well, there's not a lot of other things that really interest me as far as career goes, because I'm a very ambitious person, and I guess it's what I've always wanted to do, so I couldn't really imagine having to do something else. And I hope I never have to confront that. So.
And also, because you started, she started acting so young, that I suppose you didn't ever do another job.
No.
Did you?
No. Oh, actually... I did. I worked in a chemist.
Did you?
Pharmacy, you say pharmacy.
Or did you wear a white coat?
No, I just wore a little white dress.
Don't, and they'll all be off again. Calm down, boys, calm down. David from Surrey.
Natalie, what do you miss most about Australia?
I miss my family the most. Aww. And my friends. And Australia's very easygoing, and sometimes I miss that. Sometimes I just miss the sunshine and, you know, no worries, mate, go down the beach. So
aww.
I do love it, but it's not while I'm working. It's too far away from everywhere to really do what I do, for me anyway.
My question next. Now, you once said that, you know, your Italian blood, it means that you also have a very hot temper.
Mm-hmm.
So what does it take to make you lose it?
Oh, gosh. All the people I work with, I can feel them listening for my answer.
You can tell me if she's telling porkies.
when I get stressed out and when I'm nervous.
So, like, before you
or if somebody lies to me or things like that. I'm just very passionate about things, you know. So I think it's better to get it out and then I'm fine. I'm fine and I don't hold
and
grudges.
People are left in your wake, wounded on the floor.
It's true, but I think it's better to get that kind of stuff out.
Absolutely.
Instead of going, that's fine, no, that's fine, and really it's not, so...
And it'll damage you in the end if you keep it in.
Exactly.
Okay, right, next we're going to hear A Big Mistake.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this was the second single, and it was co-written by you.
Mm-hmm.
Is it important for you to co-write your material?
Definitely.
Are you going to be doing a lot more co-writing second album?
Yeah, I'm really interested to see, you know, I want to experiment a little bit, be a little bit more hands-on, so I'm really looking forward to seeing how much I can cope with doing myself, but we'll see.
Me too, I'm looking forward to hearing that as well. Right, more music. Here is Big Mistake. Yeah!
What a big mistake. I
Natalie Imbruglia with Big Mistake, and now I think it's time for some more questions, Natalie.
Okay, I'm ready.
Yes, are you ready? Brace yourself. Simon from Surrey.
Yep.
Oh. Going to release a new album. Can you tell us a bit about it?
I've only done about 8 demos so far for the new album because I've really been too busy and just not in the headspace. So I really don't know. There'll be new collaborations. At this stage, it's too early to say who the final songs will have been with, because I'm going to work with a lot of the same people again and some new collaborations, and I'm just going to start and see how it develops. I don't really believe in planning it too much. I just want to see how it takes its course, and hopefully it'll just naturally have progressed from the last one.
Great. Next one is from Gemma in London.
Do you feel the pressure's on to be successful with the next album?
Definitely there's a pressure there. So, like I said, I'm going to try and lock myself away and keep myself as far away from that pressure as I possibly can. Because I think if you're not relaxed and concentrating on, you know, your love of music, then you're not going to make a good album. So that's what I'm going to try and do.
Right, next one is Alexandra from Sweden.
Yeah. Are you interested in working with more experimental music like drum and bass?
Possibly, yeah. I definitely am curious. I like taking a taste of different styles and kind of making it your own. So I'm definitely going to experiment. So we'll see, maybe.
Paul from Birmingham.
How do you write? What comes first? Is it the music or the melody?
Good question. Music these days, I sound like I've been doing it for years. I first started, it was more like write poetry and then see how it develops. But now I much prefer to just sit there with the music and then
you
the
play.
Melody. No, I don't play, sorry. I play air guitar. I sit there with the air guitar, and the person I'm working with plays the real thing. No, but I like to start with the music, then the melody. I just start singing freely over the top, and it's much more organic. And I find that lyrics come very much more easily when you do it that way. So,
what does the near future hold for you?
The near future holds a trip to Australia,
yeah,
for some music awards out there, and see my family, and then I come back for a tour. So I'll just be rehearsing for that.
Of the UK.
Of the UK.
Right, mm-hmm. Brilliant.
Yes, and
then maybe relax.
Hopefully I'll get a break then. Yeah.
Okay, so all that leaves me to do now is to say a huge thank you to the audience, an enormous thank you to Natalie, yeah, and everybody at home. And you're going to play us out with your new single, aren't you?
Yes.
Smoke.
Smoke.
So here it is, Natalie performing her new single, Smoke.
Forgot how to cry.